Our Bible lesson for this morning is in the book of Exodus. We're going through the Ten Commandments, and I'm giving you reasons why we should remove the Ten Commandments out of the church. So we saw the two first commandments, and today we're going to see the next one. So Exodus 20, verse 3 through 17. You shall have no other gods before me. You shall not make for yourself an idol in the form of anything in heaven above, or on the earth beneath, or in the waters below. You shall not bow down to them or worship them, for I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God, punishing the children for the sin of the fathers to the third and fourth generation, and for those who hate me, but showing love to a thousand generations of those who love me and keep my commandments. You shall not misuse the name of the Lord your God, for the Lord will not hold anyone guiltless who misuses his name. Remember the Sabbath day by keeping it holy. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work, but the seventh day is a Sabbath to the Lord your God. On it you shall not do any work, neither you, nor your son or daughter, nor your manservant or maidservant, nor your animals, nor the alien within your gates. For in 6 days the Lord made the heaven and the earth, the sea and all that in them, but he rested on the seventh day. Therefore the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and made it holy. Honor your father and your mother, so that you may live long in the land of the Lord your God is giving you. You shall not murder. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not give false testimonies against your neighbor. You shall not covet your neighbor's house. You shall not covet your neighbor's wife, or his manservant, or maidservant, his ox, or donkey, or anything that belongs to your neighbor. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Father, help us to understand your word. Help us to apply your word in our lives. Help us to learn from you, O Lord. We pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. So today we're going to talk about the third reason of the third commandment is the third reason why we should remove. But I have someone here that wants to talk to you, but he was very upset because I think the last time I invited someone else and he was not invited and he was very upset, but don't worry. I hope everything is going to be okay. But he's here and he wants to say a few words for you. So hold on.
The right hand. Oh, any hand, all the hands that I have. If
You're going to go back to the bag and you're going to pay attention.
Okay, I can do that. Are they going to pay attention?
Yeah, they're going to try to pay attention. I hope. I pray. I pray very hard.
Okay, pray for me too.
Yes, I'm going to pray for you too.
Oh my God.
Oh, stop it.
Jesus Christ. Oh, stop it right there.
Okay. Yes, sometimes we misuse the name of the Lord. And it's very important for us to understand that the name, it's not just because of the name. In the Old Testament, in the times of the Bible, the name represented more than just identifying one person from another. It's not that. The name represented the whole person, the personality, the will, the power, the gifts, the ideas, everything was in the name. So the name had a meaning. It was very important. This is why when a person at that time had a very important and strong experience, they changed the name because the personality changed, the life changed, and they changed the name. Remember Abraham? It was Abram. And God said, okay, you're going to be more than that. You're going to be the father of the nations. And his best, he was called Abraham. And Sarah, the same thing, Sarai. Jacob had a fight with the angel and became Israel. In the New Testament, we have Saul, the persecutor of the church. And then he met Jesus and became Paul. So the name means something. So when we come to the third commandment, God said, do not misuse the name. We need to understand what God has in mind. Of course, what our friend here said, it's part of it. But it's not the only thing. And let me share with you a few lessons of what that commandment teaches. So the first thing that this commandment teaches is we do not curse in His name. We should not curse His name. We should not curse His name. And we do that in two ways. Let me share with you. The first one is using His name in a curse. We curse using His name. We say something bad using His name. We say something that is not appropriate. We put in an expression that has nothing to do with His name, and then we just throw there the name of God, like our friend here was doing. Jesus, in the prayer of the Lord, when we pray that we pray every Sunday, and maybe you pray during the week, Jesus said, this then, in Matthew 6:9, said, this then is how you should pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. The word hallowed means pure, saint, separated, special, should be treated with respect. So we do not use His name in the curse. But not only that, we do not curse God. It's not only using His name, but cursing God. But how we do that? We do that when we say things about God that is not truth and is not right. Look what Ezekiel 18:25, God says to the people. Say, you, yet you say the way of the Lord is not just. Hear, O house of Israel, is my way unjust? It is not your ways that are unjust. When we say God is not fair, that is not fair. If God was good, why He allowed this? God is not fair. God is not good. Where is the mercy of God in this situation? We are cursing God in this sense. God is good. God is merciful. God is fair. God is just. Look what God said in Isaiah 45:9. Woe to him who quarrels with his maker, to him who is but a potsherd among the potsherders and on the ground. Does the clay say to the potter, what are you making? Does your work say he has no hands? What are you doing, God, in this situation? And we quarrel with God. We should avoid that. This commandment says, don't do that. Psalm 10:11, we learn this. He says to himself, God has forgotten. He covers his face and never sees.
If you were seeing this that's happening to me, you would do something.
Many times, in some moments in our lives, we say things to God or about Him that we should never say. We should never say. So don't curse with the name of God. And don't curse God. But there is another lesson in this commandment that we need to learn. The lesson is, take your vows in His name seriously. Take your vows in His name seriously.
How many vows and promises that we make in the name of the Lord,
and we forgot, and we forget, and we don't care about it. Let me share a few of them with you. The Baptist vows, it's right there. Adult and infant, we make vows in the name of the Lord, in front of the church, that we would pray for our kids, that we would teach them about the Christian life, that we would pray with them, that we would be an example for them. All those promises, and the church made promises too. The church made promise that the church would take care of them, would help them to grow up in the presence of the Lord. Profession of faith and vows. When you made your profession of faith, you came in front of the church and said, "Yes, I will. Yes, I will be. I will participate. I will help. I will do this. I will do that. I will follow." We made all those vows. Ordination vows. Elders, deacons, pastors. All those vows that we made. And it's a long list. I remember it's a long list of promise.
Wedding vows.
I'm not going to go there.
So let's go to the next one. Yeah, we made promises. In the name of the Lord. In His presence.
We just broke. Maybe you thought God would not care. He's not going to pay attention. He's not paying attention. No, He is. He's paying attention. And look what the Bible teaches about the kind of attitude that we should have with vows and promises. The first thing that the Bible says is don't do it. That's the first thing. Look what we have in Leviticus 19:12. Do not swear falsely by my name and so profane the name of your God. I am the Lord. Don't do it. If you read Ecclesiastes, you're going to find there, don't make a vow. Don't make a vow. It's better for you not to make it than to make it and break it. So the Bible teaches that you should take serious all those vows and don't make those vows and promises. Why? Because there is a curse there. Look what Zechariah 5:4 says when he's talking about a curse. And the Lord Almighty declares, I will send it, send what? The curse out. And it will enter the house of the thief and the house of him who swears falsely by my name. It will remain in his house and destroy it, both timbers and its stones. There is a curse. We are playing with the name of God. God takes seriously his name. And then we don't understand why things are happening in our lives. It's something, there's a broken promise there that you forgot. But, gee, yes, I did that. There is one more lesson that we need to take from this commandment. Watch what you say in His name. Watch what you say in His name. That is the third lesson, the third way to misuse His name. Same things in His name that He didn't say. He didn't say that, but we say it like He said it. Oh, yes, you can do it. Oh, God, yes, God, you approve. Oh, come on, that's good. God, you can do it. And we're saying things for God that He didn't say. And we need to be very careful. Who needs to be careful? First, the leaders need to be careful. Jeremiah 27:15, we have that. I have not sent them, talking about the prophets, declared the Lord. They are prophesying lies in my name. Therefore, I will banish you, and you will perish, both you and the prophets who prophesy to you. The prophets, there was a lot of false prophets talking about God. No, this is not going to happen. God is going to going to do this, God's going to do that. And God said, I didn't say that. Then if you go to Deuteronomy 18:20, it gets worse. This is what God said. But a prophet who presumes to speak in my name anything I have not commanded him to say, or a prophet who speaks in the name of other gods, must be put to death. God is serious about his word and his name. In 2 Peter 2:1, Peter says, wrote this, but there were also false prophets among the people. Just as there will be false teachers among you, they will secretly introduce destructive heresies, even denying the sovereign Lord who bought them, bringing swift destruction on themselves. False teachers. People that will come and say, this is what the Bible says. And they will take you to the other path and move you from God and take you away from the Lord. And the Lord said, hey, be careful what you say in my name. But it's not only the leaders. The people have the responsibility too. We need to be careful what we say about the Lord. Look what the Job, we have in Job 13:7-9. We will speak deceitfully for him. We will show him partiality. Will you argue the case for God? Would it turn out well if he examined you? Could you deceive him as you might deceive man? Say, are you going to speak for God? Do you know what he means? Do you know what he's talking about? Do you know his opinion so you can share? If not, don't say it, that it's God. You say, it's my opinion. It's better. So watch what you say. And why this is important for us? Because there are consequences. There are personal consequences when we misuse the name of the Lord. There are personal consequences. Acts 27, right there on the commandment, it says, for the Lord will not hold anyone guiltless who misuses his name. There's personal consequences for us when we misuse his name. When you say things about the Lord that is not true. When you say things to the Lord that is not true. When you curse, we curse using his name. Or when you say something that the Lord said and he didn't. There's personal consequence. But not only that. There is outside, external consequences with people around us. Look what Paul wrote to Romans 2:24. As it is written, God's name is blasphemed among the Gentiles because of him. Every time that we say something about God that is not true, people will listen. Every time that we do something that is not coherent with our Christian behavior, the way that we should behave, and people will see, and they will curse God. They will curse God. And we need to be very careful with that. They will blaspheme God. They say, see, this is how Christians behave. He is a Christian. She is a Christian. Look what they did. Look how they did. And they will blaspheme God. So there's consequence when we do that. As you can see, we are so used to misuse the name of the Lord. That the third commandment has no place in the church. Has no place. We should remove that. Because we are saying things that we're not supposed to say. We do not agree with God. We are using his name to curse. We're breaking our vows. And we're saying things that he said that he didn't say. Remove this commandment from the church. Or we should start practicing this commandment. Let us bow our heads and let us pray. Father, help us to understand your word and help us to apply your word in our lives. We pray that your Spirit will help us to glorify your name, to respect. respect your name and not misuse your name. Help us to do that. Give us discipline. We pray in the name of Jesus.